Chapter 1. My name is Dr. Frederick J. I am a doctor at the London Hospital. One day, in 1884, I saw a picture in the window of a shop near the hospital. I stopped in front of the shop and looked at the picture. I read the writing under the picture. It said, "Come in and see the elephant man, 2 pence." I opened the door and went in. There was a man in the shop.
What do you want? What do you want?
Hey, yeah, yeah, leh. Ah, ni buat.
What do you want?
I like to see the elephant man, please.
Well, you cannot. The shop closing now.
You can come back tomorrow. I'm sorry, but I would like to see him now. I have no time tomorrow. I have a lot of work to do. But I can give you more than 2 pence, if you like.
Alright, sir. Give me 12 pence then. Stand up.
Korang buat pakaian apa ni?
Walk, Mary. Walk. Nice, nice. Come on, quickly, move. Alright. Thank you. Let me sit down. I want to see anymore.
Yes, sir. Sit down, Mary.
Ni siapa pandai make up ni tu? Nampak real lah.
Wonderful, sir. Isn't it? The best elephant man in England. Hundreds of people come to see him. You know, hundreds. I take him all over the country. I do.
Yes. Very interesting. Can I sit down?
Oh, yes, sir. Of course.
Ini tu macam bang ni. Tak cukup prop. Tak cukup prop. Tak prop mana? Alah, kata kipu.
Kau dah nampak orang kan? Kan? Body kan? Yes, sir, of course.
Of course. Thank you.
Would you like a glass of water?
No. Yes, please.
Semua tu terhuduh kan?
Where's the water? Where's the water?
Dua puluh minit dah.
No. Thank you. I'm all right. Do you call the creature Mary?
That's right, sir. Say Joseph Mary. The best elephant man in England. I take him all over the country. You know, lots of people want to see him.
Yes, I see. Do you get a lot of money?
Well, sometimes we do, sir. Yes. But it's yang difficult. You see, sir, because of the police. The police don't like us, you see, sir. So we cannot stay in the town very long. We usually move every week.
Yes, I see. Yeah. Well, anyway, Mr.
Silcock. Sir Simon Silcock.
Okay. I think this man, Joseph Merrick, is very interesting. And I would like to see him at the hospital. I want to look at him more carefully, you see?
Yes, sir, I see. But how can he get to the hospital? It's going to be difficult.
Why not? The hospital is not too far from here.
Well, yes, sir, I know. But you see, Mary cannot walk very well. He needs help.
You can come with him. Do you want my money?
Well, yes, sir, I do. But you see, people are afraid of him too. In the road, little boys always run after him and hit him.
I see. Well, how can he come to hospital then?
Bring a cab, sir. We can take him to the hospital in a cab.
Mana Mr. Cab? Ramai.
Next day, at 7 o'clock, I came to the shop in a cab. I waited 5 minutes. A postman walked past.
A fish. Blue.
Then, the door of the shop opened and the creature Mary came out.
Good morning, Mr. Mary. Can you get in?
My steps.
I'm sorry. I don't understand.
Itu buat apa tu?
Step.
Apa ni? Step.
Oh. Yes, I see. I'm sorry.
Dia keluar taksi lah.
Let me help you.
Dia buat arak. Kau senang bawa memang warna taksi lah.
Lupa.
Rambut dia naik. Open lah pintu tu. Boleh di sini cepat.
Hello, sir.
Can I help you? Okay, hello.
Yes, but this is a lady, not a gentleman. I'm a doctor, and she's ill. Take her hand, so I can help her better.
There are two naughty boys.
Get off here!
Duduk lah tu. Ya.
Kau tak
final
dah. Ya. Tak kan.
Ya, nak cakap.
Dia cakap.
Handsome.
Thank you. It's okay, sir. She is a strange lady, sir, isn't she? She's ill, that's all. We're going to the hospital. Bye.
Gila-gila lah. Bau. Mata mana bol mata?
Kau lebih bergetar lima bulan.
Tenis.
Bawa kuda kan? Betul-betul kau kata
banyak ni. Oh, zaman ni kan kuda.
Pakai kuda. That was difficult, wasn't it? It's times are very difficult, but most things are very difficult for me. Yes, I think it's easy for you, isn't it? Now, who are you, sir? Who am I? Oh, I'm sorry. Here, that's my card. Thank you.
One day, the police found him.
Thank you for finding him and bring him here. You are welcome, sir.
Kalau dia kata. Mana yang baca dia tak ada.
Dia tak
ada. Bodoh dia tu bodoh. Kalau dia bapak pun.
Bagi apa topi.
I told the hospital chairman, Mr. Cargo, about Mary.
Dear sir, I am writing to you about a man in our hospital. He needs your help. His name is Joseph Mary, and he is 27 years old. He is not ill, but he cannot go out of the hospital because he is very, very ugly. Nobody likes to look at him, and some people are afraid of him. We call him the Elephant Man. 2 years ago, Mary lived in a shop near the London Hospital. For 2 pence, people could see him and laugh at him.
One day, Dr. Frederick Trish, a hospital doctor, saw Mary brought him to this hospital and looked at him carefully. Dr. Trish could not help Mary, but he gave him his card. Then the shopkeeper, Sukong, took Mary to Belgium. A lot of people in Belgium wanted to see him, and so after a year, Mary had $50. But then Sukong took Mary's $50, left Mary in Belgium, and went back to London. Mary came back to London by himself.
Jangan tiup, tolong jangan tiup.
Everyone on the train and the ship looked at him and laughed at him. In London, the police put him in prison. But then they saw Dr. Trish card and brought Merrick to the London hospital. This man has no money and he cannot work. His face and body are very, very ugly. So of course many people are afraid of him. But he is a very interesting man. He can write and write, he can read and write, and he thinks a lot. He is a good, quiet man. Sometimes he makes things with his hand and gives them to the nurses because they are kind to him. He remembers his mother and he says, and he has a picture of her. She was beautiful and kind, he says, but he never sees her now. She gave him to Sulkot a long time ago. Can the readers of the Times help us? This man is not ill, but he needs a home. We can give him a room at the hospital, but we need some money. Please write to me at the London Hospital. Yours faithfully, Cargo, Chairman of the London Hospital.
After 1 week, we had £50,000, so Merrick could live in the hospital for all his life. We gave Merrick 2 rooms at the back of the hospital. I visited him every day and talked to him. One day, a new nurse came to the hospital and nobody told her about Mary. She took his food to his room and opened the door. What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Dr. Chiefs.
You know you cannot yell at him, you know? He's a person like us. He's a kind person. You must promise to me that you won't do the same thing.
Yes, I promise.
People don't like looking at me. I know that. But at least there is a bit of ice cream.
Well, I don't want nurses to laugh at you, Joseph. I want them to help you.
Thank you, doctor. But it's not important. Everyone laughs at me. I understand that. Dr. Cleves, you and the nurses are very kind, and I'm very happy here. Thank you very much. I know I can stay here long, and I would like to live in lighthouse after the hospital. Please, a lighthouse or a home for blind people. I think those are the best places for me.
Why?
Lighthouses has
around them, then do. Nobody could look at me in a lighthouse, so I will be happy there. And blind people can't see any, can see no, nothing, so they couldn't see me, could they? Not yourself. This is your home. You live here now. You aren't going to leave the hospital. Not today, perhaps. But soon, you are a very kind man, Dr. Trees. But I can stay here long. I have no money. Joseph, this is your home now. Don't you understand? You can stay here all your life. Hello, today I will show you some of my good friends. His name is Joseph Mary, or also known as the Elephant Man.
Okay, thank you. Good morning, Mr. Mary.
Good morning.
My name is Imelda. I'm here to meet you.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad to see you.
Don't cry.
Okay. Thanks for coming.
You're welcome. I have things to run. I'll come again to visit you. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Yes.
The week after that, she came again with a friend. Hi, Mr. Mary.
Hi, Imelda.
Today I came with my best friend. She is a very beautiful and kind.
Oh yeah, who is it?
Good morning, Mr. Mary.
Good morning. Have the seat.
I'm Emma. I've heard a lot about you. So how do you do, Mr. Mary?
I'm fine, thank you.
Mary, tell her about your reading.
Oh yeah, I like reading.
Joseph, this is Her Majesty, Queen Alexandra, the Queen of England. Have a nice day.
I'm very pleased to meet you. No, please, Mr. Mary, do get out. I would like to talk to you. Can we sit at your table?
Yes, yes, of course.
Mana sini, Kisina.
I also read about you in the newspaper. You are a very interesting man, Mr. Mary. You have a difficult life, right? People say you are happy now. Is it true? Are you happy?
Oh yes, Your Majesty, yes. I am a very happy man. I have a home here now, and my friends, and my books. I am happy every hour of the day.
What a wonderful story. I am very pleased to hear it. Now tell me about your reading. I see you have got a book here.
Yes, Your Majesty. I love my books.
Dia kata limit. The limit.
Mary, I have to go now. There are some gifts for you.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye. I promise anytime you call me, it don't matter where I am, I'll always be there, like you've been there, even in the closer, I'll be right over, I'll say.
Christmas, the Queen sent a Christmas card to Mary.
Posto.
Oh. Okay. We sent this 20 December 1888. Dear Joseph, here is a small Christmas present for you. I think it looks like me, doesn't it? I do like visiting you very much, and I'm going to come to the hospital again in the new year. Happy Christmas, your friend Alexandra.
The present was a picture of Queen Alexandra with her name on it. Mary cried over it and put it carefully by the bed in his room. Then he sat down and wrote a letter to the Queen. It was the first letter of his life. My dear Queen, thank you very, very much for your wonderful card and the beautiful picture. It is the best thing in my room, the very best, the most beautiful thing I have. It is the first Christmas in my life and my first Christmas present. Perhaps I had a Christmas with my mother once, but I do not remember it. I have my mother's pictures too, and she is beautiful, like you. But now I know many famous ladies and kind people like Dr. Chief, and I am very happy man. I am happy too because I am going to see you in the new year. Happy Christmas to you, my dear friend. With all my love, Joseph Mary.
Boleh jalan lah.
After Christmas, he wanted to go to the theater. This was very difficult because I did not want the people in the theater to see him. But a kind lady from the theater, Mrs. Kendall, helped us.
Thank you.
come on faster.
Hello.
Hi.
My name is Dr. Treves.
Okay.
Today I will bring some special guests.
Who's that?
His name is Joseph Carey Mary.
Oh. Okay.
Can you allow us to enter the theater using the Queen's door?
Oh yes, of course. Let's.
Theater.
Come with me.
Jangan pegang. Jangan pegang.
Slowly. Sekejap. Have a seat, Joseph, Mary and Dr. Treve. Thank you. Enjoy the theater.
I saw you talk to the dead man last evening. Why was that man?
He's just my friend and we're talking about our problem. Are you jealous with me?
Yes, I'm jealous. What's wrong with you? Oh, you are my girlfriend. I love you so much.
But I don't love you. Don't you realize that? How dare you? Get out of my life!
Go in.
Wait, terus kau. Terus kau win.
Very excited.
Baru tumbuk sekali dah kahwin. Tipi apa ni?
What do you think they did after we left? Where do the young
That's the best what I did.
What do you think they did after we left? Where do the young lady and the young man live? What are they doing now? I want to know that.
I don't know. Perhaps they live in the country.
The truth. Can I go to the
country? Tadi.
I saw the country once from a train, but I never went there. I've often read about it in book. It's very beautiful, isn't it? I would like to see it.
I would like.
At the country. Hello, Mr. Mary.
Hello.
Mr. Chief.
Okay.
I heard you want to stay in country. I have a beautiful house there. If you don't mind, you can stay there during the summer.
Are you serious? Seriously?
Yes, yes. Here the key.
Here is the key.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Okay, stop. Teacher.
Azmin bagi tahu tak di meja bila? Tuan, Azmin bagi tahu tak di meja bila?
Entah. Ini apa?
Oh.
Sial lah.
Merrick did not usually sleep on his bed. His enormous head was very heavy, so he usually sat up in bed with his arms round his legs and his head on his knees. He could sleep well like this. But 6 months later, in April 1980, I found him dead in the bed. He wanted to sleep on his back like you and me. He tried to sleep on his back that night. But his heavy head came off the back and he broke his neck. He died very quickly.
Tak ada pula kalau macam combat lah. Tak sangka aku merakam adik aku.
Joseph? Joseph? Joseph?
The next day, the chairman of the London Hospital, Mr. Cargo, wrote to the editor of the Times again.
Hi doctor, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Come in. You sit down.
Thank you.
Doctor, why you come to my office?
There's something very important I will tell you.
What happened? Doctor?
It's about Joseph Terry Mary.
What happened with him?
Last night, he just broke his neck and died quickly.
What? Are you joking with me? I don't know you what.
No. This is a true story. And I won't lie about it.
Okay. I will go to a letter to the editor, the Times newspaper.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Dear sir, 3.5 years ago, I wrote to you about a man called Joseph Merrick. This man was called the Elephant Man because he was born with a very ugly body. Merrick was not ill, but he could not work and he had no money. The readers of the Times felt sorry for him and they gave me a lot of money for Merrick. Because of this money, we could give Merrick a home in the London hospital. It was his first good home and for 3.5 years, he lived here happily. The doctors and nurses of the hospital helped him and many important people visited him. He read many books, he went to the theatre, and in the summer he stayed in the country for 6 weeks. Because of your readers' money, we could give him a happy life. Last night, Joseph Mary died quietly in his bed. He was a man with a very ugly body, but he was a good man, a good kind man, and he had a lot of friends. We like to talk to him, and we are all very sorry because he is dead. A lot of people are going to remember him for a long time. There is some money left, so I am going to give it to the hospital. Thank you, sir, for your help. Yours faithfully, Cargo, Chairman of the London Hospital.
Thank you for watching. That's all. Thank you so much.